The point is that we have a poster up today which describes the results of one study that, along with six other studies, make us fairly reasonably convinced that the device that I have here is actually moderately effective in reducing blood pressure. And that's kind of amazing, because when I started this work, amongst my many birth defects are I was born in the state of Missouri. And as you may know, in Missouri, our state motto is show me. And I wish to have it proved to me that this device, which one uses on a good day for 15 minutes, perhaps as infrequently as 3 to 4 times a week, would be able to lower blood pressure measured hours, days, and weeks after taking the instruction on how to take these exercises. Now, it's a strange and interesting little device in that because of the miracle of miniaturization, it's only about this big. In fact, this is one. It works by a computer on the inside, which is hooked up to a band that goes around one's thorax or abdomen so that it can monitor your breathing, because the idea is to have the machine assist you in achieving a breathing rate of less than 10 breaths per minute, but more importantly perhaps to increase the amount of exhalation, the process of getting rid of the air, as compared to the other process which is taking it in. Now, of course, you should take out as much as you bring in, that's not the issue, but the time spent in exhalation is the thing that this device seems to help you do. What happens is you put the headphones on, these are headphones, most are familiar with this, you put these things on and they give you a series of tones that you hear in the headphones that lead you to slow down your breathing as well as to increase the time that you spend in exhalation. And via various interesting physiological mechanisms, we believe that that process of increasing the time of exhalation, as well as slowing the breathing in general, do interesting things to the stretch receptors in the lungs, thereafter sending messages to the brain, thereafter sending messages down through the nervous system into the arteries to allow them to open and to stay open, even after you've stopped using the device, and even after your breathing pattern has gone back to the original that you had before, which for most of us is between 16 and 18 breaths per minute. So the fun part is that this device needed to be tested, and it has been tested in several studies in other places. But we wanted to do a study that was different than all the other ones. Because as you may know, and as you may have heard in some of the previous discussions, there is always the concern that people who sign up for these things and these studies are much more motivated than the usual person. They get much more specific personal attention from the doctor and the nurse and the people who work in the clinic so that they get better information. They get more exclusive one-on-one tutoring, etc., etc. So we decided to do a study that was different than those, where in fact the only thing that we had to do when the person visited the office was to come and sign a consent document to say that they were interested in receiving it to help them manage their blood pressure. And then to come again at the end of the study so that we could measure their blood pressure, which we also did at the beginning. Okay? So these people had no contact with doctors, nurses, or other people in the time that they were in the study. And all they did was to receive a box a little bigger than this with exactly the same sort of thing. The device, an instruction book, and unlike the commercial product, there was no video. Okay? So this is written instructional. And we were amazed to find that, in fact, 95% of the people who got the device actually used it correctly. I should say that the little computer on the inside is much smarter than you might think. It actually remembers not only how often you use the device, but how much slow breathing you achieve during the exercise, because it keeps track of that sort of thing, not only as telling you the information so that it helps you slow down your breathing and lower your blood pressure, but in fact it keeps that in memory. So for an 8-week time period, we were able to see what happened to the people, and the most amazing thing is, probably no surprise to you, the people who did not use the device did not receive any benefit from it, lowering blood pressure. That's a good piece of it. But people who used it a little bit did a little better, and people who used it a lot, like they were supposed to, 15 minutes, 3 to 4 times a week, they received a very nice reduction in blood pressure, almost exactly the same as has been seen in other studies where the doctor and the nurse go and lecture the patient on how to use it, and they demonstrate its use and all that sort of thing. This was done by getting a package through the mail, through a courier service. No special instruction. And it shows us, I think, that number one, Americans, these were all American people, They can read the instructions. That's good. They can use the device appropriately, and that's good. And if they use it according to the instructions, they actually do lower their blood pressure. So that's kind of the take-home message for our little study. Perhaps there would be questions. I apologize for the short speech.